How is a Bio Blitz done? Basically, you get a whole bunch of people who are totally obsessed about science and the outdoors and the environment, and you let them go. You just have them collect everything they can find. We photograph it, we document it, we subsample it for DNA, we preserve it for museums. Basically, you get people who are passionate about what they do and set them loose.
We are right now at Galbraith Island in the central British Columbian coast. The Hakai Institute has a great field station here.
It's transitionary between the southern areas and the cold water fauna of Alaska, and so it's very rich, and it's also an area that is likely to be changing as the climate changes, and so it's an important place to really understand.
So the British Columbia coastline is one of the most complex in the world. We have access here to a huge archipelago of thousands of different islands, to inland fjords and protected areas, a ton of different habitats from seagrasses to mudflats to rocky shores and subtidal reefs as well. In parallel with that, we have a huge diversity of animals. This area, really globally, is probably a hotspot for biodiversity. But we have to understand what's there, what role the different organisms play, and how things are connected to one another. In this era of global change, biodiversity is changing really quickly. And without an understanding of what's there, what the initial baseline biodiversity is, we don't really have a great sense of how things are changing, why things are changing, and what the impacts of this change will be down the road.
So one of the goals of the BioBlitz is to establish a baseline of what's known of the life of an area that can be then compared to other areas and also compared from now into the future. It's a baseline of sorts for understanding what the impacts of environmental change, climate change, fishing, and so on are. And these are very critical to people as well as to the environment.
The Hakai Institute actually collects biodiversity information all year long. But this is the first time that we're really zooming in on the fauna and the flora that we have on Galbraith Island.
So this is an opportunity for us to really kickstart ourselves into a formal study of biodiversity here.
So we're bringing together specialists in several different fields for a concerted 3-week effort.
MarineGEO is the Marine Global Earth Observatory. This is a growing global network of marine scientists and institutions that are working together to understand how coastal ecosystems work.
So Hakai was one of the earliest members of MarineGEO and currently the most northerly station in North America.
We are one node in a global network, which aim is to understand global changes in biodiversity.
The BioBlitz is like a giant scavenger hunt by biologists.
We have one team out in the exposed coast sampling rocky intertidal habitats. On the same day, we also have another team on the protected coast sampling open mudflats and seagrass habitats.
So we collect the specimens and bring them back to the lab where they're cataloged very carefully. So we identify each species, take a picture of it, and then we get a DNA barcode, which allows you to identify that species and distinguish it from others. And so by having all of those things together, we have a really detailed catalog of the life of the area.
We're tallying a list of species, making field guides. Apparently, several of the species that we've been finding are new to science. Right now, there's so many species running through my head. It's been a whirlwind trying to keep track of all of these new discoveries. Every day is exciting.
It's just been just wonderful. I mean, it's just amazing to go out there and be in the boat, look around yourself, not a soul in sight, you know, go on the beaches and see footprints of all sorts of wildlife, just luscious nature all around you, and then hit the water, and after that chill, you go down to the bottom and you turn over a rock and there's something totally unexpected. It's what I live for.
What we try to do at Hakai is to take the time and the patience to study a particular part of the world in great detail. Study it long term, study it patiently, study it year round, really come to an understanding of what's happening here. I think that that is necessary to really understand our environment. What we then really want to do is to not just look at our space, but think about how it compares with other places around the world.
Because as it turns out, we know very little about life on this planet.
And estimating biodiversity really for us comes down to one thing. What do we have here? How do we manage it for not only our current benefit, but for future generations? You can't manage something if you don't know what you have.
We still are living on a planet that's fairly unaltered, where organisms are still in a quasi-natural state in most places. And for people to know what that was like, what to strive for in future management, they need to have that information. Just imagine what you would pay to go back to the age of the dinosaurs and see T-Rex. We have that opportunity today to look at all the T-Rexes out there and describe them before they disappear. And I think this, for biologists, this is one of the most important things they can do in this generation.